Hades 21. Is the rich man in the parable in the hell of the demon or in the Hades? Is the rich man in the parable in the hell of the demon or is he in the Hades, the Sheol, the passage of death? This is a real question that arises when you look at all the fathers of the church up to the time of Benedict XVI. The doctors of the church all said that he was in hell of the demon. They relied upon the fact that at one point Abraham answered this particular rich man, as it is found in Luke chapter 16 verse 19 onwards. He answers, "A dike has been placed between you and us who are in paradise, Abraham's bosom, in such a way that you cannot come here." And so some have interpreted that this dike was forever, and therefore the rich man, who nevertheless seems repentant, who prays so that his brother be warned that they do not arrive in this place of suffering, by which he begs for the grace to be given to him, which seems to thirst for God. This man seems damned for eternity, founded upon the formationist explanation. A theory had been developed during the Middle Ages as to what in hell men repenting, but because they did not know Christ nor did not love Christ at the time of their death, and therefore after their death they arrived without grace, could be damned, a bit like a lottery. When the axe fell, our repentance of this eternal hell of God's justice applies. It was too late, too bad for them. In reality, when we look more closely at the biblical text, it does not say that he is in the hell of the demon. It states that he is in the Hades. In other words, the passage of death, the hell. For the first time in 2007, in an encyclical bearing magisterial authority, Special V at number 44 and 45, Pope Benedict XVI addressed this text, and against all tradition, he probably said that this rich man, for him the sentence has not been pronounced, he is not definitive hell, probably more like that he is in purgatory. That means that this rich man had been condemned to purify himself through the sufferings which he lives, that he did not live while upon earth to acquire a heart ready for the salvation which will be proposed to him. It changes everything. At the moment, his attitude, full of concern for his brothers and who thirsts for grace, becomes explicable. He cannot be damned because he is repentant. What happened to him? Like putting things back together? Pope Benedict XVI continues in Special V at number 47 and says some theologians say that the appearance of Christ to those who are in the passage of death, this is what shows them their own sanity, which upsets them deep within their hearts, and seeing him, seeing his face, his tears, his heartbeat, they find salvation there. They can be saved. The Pope does not make it a dogma of faith. He proposes it to the church, but then he advances theological research enormously. It would seem that the famous text of Saint Peter in his first epistle, chapter 3, verse 19, takes on its meaning when he says, "It is he, Jesus, who went even to preach to the spirits who were in prison, to those who once refused to believe when God was patient, and that on the day that Noah built his ark, in which a small number in all 8 people were saved from drowning in the water." Water means purification by suffering. So, before concluding, a small objection must be given. a pope in a solemn, infallible dogma, Pope Benedict XII during the Middle Ages, a pope from Avignon, said we must hold it as a revealed truth that after death, a man who does not have grace is damned for eternity immediately. There is no salvation for him, and so we should say that it's impossible to interpret this in such a way. They are after death. The rich man is after death. It is too late. He is damned. We cannot turn the solemn dogma into a lie. In reality, the solution is very simple. It is that we interpreted this dogma of Pope Benedict XII as after death. That means after biological death, after heart failure. Well, obviously, these are words coming from the Holy Spirit, who speaks of the doctrine of salvation. It is after death in the biblical sense. Therefore, the passage between this world and the next, sometimes called the Sheol or the Hades, the passage wherein souls have not yet seen Christ, where the angel of the Lord may at some point, as for the time in the Old Testament, announce to them this salvation to come, then they can turn to him, so that after this passage, after death, if someone is not in the state of grace, it is because he has refused it perfectly, lucidly, in total self-control. This is blasphemy against the Holy Spirit. They are immediately damned because they want to be damned.